Welcome to my channel. My name is Mildred and it's afternoon. I just got back from shopping. I went to Blokker and Lego because yesterday I got an email from Blokker that they had a They had a lot of Lego and some of them were priced down. So yesterday, before I was uploading that video about embossing folder, that's why I was posting it so late. I was going through all the 45 pages on a Blokker of all the Lego items that they have in their inventory, and of course a lot of them are not available anymore, but still they had it in their list. I don't know why they didn't take that out. I had really go page by page, 45 pages, and some of them were really good prices. Some were old sets that I have never heard of, because like I said before in my previous vlogs videos, I said that on Instagram I came up a post that Lego at the end of January, when was that? 28th of January, I believe, they posted something like there is a Lego Day, an International Lego Day, and that they were making some loud noises about it, you know, making some advertisements. So I thought to myself, Lego, that is something from my very, very past. And I used to play with that, and I put that aside because, of course, life goes on. You have to do some adulting. So I thought to myself, okay, let's see what's Lego all about. So suddenly I was sucked in and I was Lego crazy. So since then, February, March, April, May, also 4 months, 3 or 4 months, I was like Lego crazy, Lego frenzy. And I was looking at all these sets, and I know not by heart some prices, some sets that I really, really, really want, but I cannot afford the sets above 40 euros. So then that's out of the question. So I need to play something with my hands. I have nothing to show you. I'm sorry. So all these sets that I also want are above like 100 euros and even above that. And that's why I was looking at this with huge interest at that Blokker site. And then I saw something and I didn't understand what it meant. It said 2 hours after opening, there were some sets that were free. And I'm like, what? So there were two sets that I was interested in, and I was trying to rush out of the door, but I was still on Instagram and I saw a Instagrammer, Creative Letters, saying, hey, reach out, I'm interested in a pen pal from the Netherlands. And I thought by myself, okay, I am from Rotterdam, the Netherlands. So as I was writing some stuff at her post, and she wanted to talk, and I feel so bad. I had to go out because it was already 3 o'clock, and my mind was so stupid. I thought I had to go like after 2 o'clock, go out and try to find these two sets so I can get them for free. And maybe find the other sets that I want for some lower prices. I did find some sets that I want like 10 euros, 18 euros. I did purchase them, even though my list is like this big. I can't show you how big. It's very, very big. But I need to do it in the frame, so that's why it seems like, oh, that's not so much. It's my list is big. So but my train of thought is gone. Yeah, so I was in the store. Winkel is Dutch for store. I was in the store and I did find some stuff, and I bought some things because, you know, if you buy small stuff of small amounts, small prices, they add up. Then you realize when you go to the cash register to pay and you realize, oh my god, I hurt my wallet so much. But then I said to myself, I cannot put it back because this is now. The sale is, it's not really sale, they don't advertise it as sale. They just say like, hey, to bring the matches out in the world, we have Legos and we want to sell it at those prices. So when I compare with the price of Amazon, the Lego.com and the Play Today from Gouda and all the other stores like the Blokker and the Kruidvat, I thought by myself, I need to go out today and I need to go out. So I regret that I didn't talk to Creative Letters, but I still send some messages like, when I come back, I want to talk to you further. So I hope that she will send me some little note, because I'd love to be one of her pen pals. And I was thinking yesterday, so I hope I don't spend too much on the Lego from Blokker and Kruidvat, because I need to go Lego.com to buy the newest latest sets of the Lego dots. The one of the 1,000 pieces in a set and the other one. Because actually the other box, it has small things like the cloud. So you have a base plate. I don't know if I can show this small piece in any kind of color. They have it in, oops, sorry. Oh, I lost this curl. Oh gosh. Now I'm just come on. I don't understand, come on. Okay, so these small plates, there are also other sizes, so you can, there are different kind of sizes. We call them base plates. The actual base plate is like this, 16 by 16 or 32 by 32. I believe there's also 48. I don't know, I think. So there was in that set of the Lego, there was a base plate in the shape of a cloud. I know that in the past, I saw it in YouTube from the other YouTube influencers from Canada and from America, that they have in like a small sets or packs, or I don't know. There was indeed a shape like a cloud, but they had also with the Lego dots you can create rainbows, so it was standing. But never mind, I can never get that set anymore. It's already out. I think they'll never sell it again. I can maybe try to find it on Bricklink or the other ways you can find Lego that is not anymore in fashion. Of course I can go to Amazon and all the other online stores in the Netherlands, but then you get the second market, and that means that the first market that's on the official LEGO website store, there is a certain price. Sometimes it's reasonable price, sometimes not. But after it's gone out of fashion, the second market, that means that all the other players can sell it for a higher price, like 15 or 20 euros above the actual original price. So that means it's gonna be expensive if you didn't buy it then, because you're now planning to buy it now, if you know what I mean. So some other sellers, I have studied retail because I went to school for retail, business school. And I know that, I'm gonna tell you now, that if one retailer or seller or the original person that tries to sell something that's unique, then the other people is looking at it and think, hey, I can sell that too. I can be a businessman too. I can do that retail too. I can do that online thing too. So they think about, I can make money. I can buy the stuff when it's in fashion and when it's a bit like on sale or priced down, they can buy the stuff in bulk. And then they hoard it and wait it till it's out of fashion, so they can sell it for 15 or 20 euros above the price, the original price, or they can double it or triple it or quadruple it, the original price. So if you are crazy enough and you have the money, then you can do that. I, on the other hand, cannot. I cannot afford to pay stupid money for something that I could have bought then. So I have to make some decisions to buy or not to buy, or delay and park it in my mind, in the back of my mind, like, I'm not gonna buy it now, maybe later, maybe a month later or 2 months later, because you have to watch out when sometimes sets can get out of fashion. So it will be out of stock and it will never come back. So you have some kind of deadline also. If you want to buy Lego or you're interested, as I am AFOL, so a fan of Lego, that is what it means. AFOL, a fan of Lego. So then you have the other thing, that you have things from the past that still is sellable, and you have things now that will still be sold, but maybe they're limited edition, they will never come back. And then there's also the thing like, there are new stuff coming. So yeah, you are bombarded at every corner, every side of your surroundings, like, hey, there's also this and there's also that. Then you have the other point, is that with the actual Lego bricks and elements and little things, you can create something beautiful, and that is called mock, my own creation. So if you have something in your mind and you create something very beautiful, you can keep it to yourself and make, if you are on social media, and you can take a picture and you say, hey, I made this. But if you want to make money, you can sell it. Then you can earn some money with your own creation. But there's also something at Lego Ideas that you can post something on Lego Ideas, like, hey, I created this, it's my own creation. And if Lego loves it enough, they can buy your creation and market it and sell it internationally. So your name will be attached to that particular set. And then you can make money on that way too. So there's, so you can be an active or a not so active player or member, or how do you say it? I'm not so active, as you can see. I buy the stuff, I play with it, I build it, I craft it, I enjoyed putting on my table, as you can see. Maybe I need to focus a little bit further. Can I? Okay, maybe, is it better? I cannot, let's see if I can make a bit more space on my magic stand. Okay, it's not standing quite horizontal. It's a bit wonky, I'm sorry. So my mind is now running amok, because actually my official name of my channel was actually my name, Mildred Lee. But because I was into Lego in January this year, 2021, I changed it into Fat Dandelions. And then, because of Lego, I changed it again in A Folly Fat Dandelions. So now I'm thinking, shall I change my name, A Folly Fat Dandelions, back to Fat Dandelions and create a new channel with A Folly Fat Dandelions, where I can put all other toys and interest on that channel. And this channel, Fat Dandelions, actually is the original name, do the crafting, because I want to show you a lot of things. And I cannot show you because I have to divide my attention between the crafting, the toys, the Lego, and it's too much. I have realized like 2-3 months, like, I cannot show you a lot of crafting because of divided attention. So, can you tell me, should I put back the A Folly Fat Dandelion, A Folly Fat Dandelions, shall I replace it back to Fat Dandelions and create a whole other channel as A Folly Fat Dandelions with Lego and other toys? So, and other interest. So I can put 100% on the crafting on one channel, and the other channel is more toys that I buy. Toys are actually for kids, but some adults like me and others love to play with toys. And sometimes the toys are so expensive that normal children cannot buy them. You have to have a credit card or a debit card or a debit account and the other stuff to pay for these things. And most of the adults are of age that their kids are not kids anymore. So they are playing with the toys. They are paying it for themselves. So that's why I love the name Avol. I'm drinking water. So this is my talk. I hope you can help me with, and help me decide what to do with my channel. Because yesterday, when I did the embossing folder, I had a painful realization, like, I have so many embossing folders and clear stamps and wooden stamps. And as you can see in the background, all these metal stamp heads for the wax seals. I have printed paper, pattern paper pad, notepad. There's so much paper, stickers, rub-ons, metal dies. There's so much stuff of the crafting world. Oh, and I have talk about inks, fountain pens, hand lettering, brush markers, acrylic paint. There's so much. I already knew that before I started, but I thought I could contain it well enough and guide it, you know, guide it well enough and divide equally my time. But now after 2 years, this is my third year of doing YouTube. I am in a pickle. Like, there's so much that I want to show you, but I can't unless I do like 10 vlogs a day, and that's also impossible. You cannot do it day by day. So, and people will be flooded with so many vlogs or videos from me that they will getting tired of me. I've noticed that I've gained some actual subscribers, and from 55 to 57 to 59, and now I'm dropped back down to 55. And depressed by these numbers that they are going down? Of course it hurts me that people have left, because I am hoping that I will get to the amount of 3,000 subscribers, but my channel is not unique enough. I am the same like all the others, and I try to be different and stand out and try not to do the same thing as the others. So I know I am a little bit sad by the decreasing of the numbers, but it's not that it hurts me so much that I'm so depressed. I can cope it.